almost three quarters of the positives in the last 3 days have come out of Cass County. We want to make sure that we are there and trying to stop the spread of those, of the people associated with those that are coming up positive. So we'll keep driving on that and give you more of an update on Wednesday. As far as testing shortage, again, you saw that our numbers were lower today in testing than they have been when we cleared the 2,000 mark and we're back down to 1,300. And you know we've been aggressively trying to ramp up our testing capacity just in the state lab alone, which did typically even a big day in the COVID days, 195 tests per day would have been a big number, and that would have covered all kinds of things, not just a single disease category like COVID. But now we're running that lab three shifts, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and have built capacity to do over 2,000 tests a day and trying to grow that to 4,000 and then trying to grow it beyond that. And so again, we are building that capacity, but that capacity also depends on availability of assortment of supply. That all need to come together through a supply chain. And today we did run into a shortage of deep well plates on our thermal Fisher testing machine. This unit has 19 different consumable pieces that must be on hand to run one test. I know some people think all we need is a swab and a machine and away you go, but this is a super complicated work, and the team has been doing a great job on this. And of course, in this environment they're in normal times, supply chain management can be challenging. But now when we're competing against all other 50 states, you've got FEMA, you've got other federal agencies that are in, that are competing, trying to move orders around to the hotspots, of which we're not. But our team has done a great job of allowing us to grow, as we said, and move up to number four in the nation in tests per capita. But we did have a glitch here related to these shortage of deep well plates. And for a while, we thought that was going to be a major holdup. The good news, it turns out that through our research universities, in particular the NDSU Diagnostic Lab, had 100 of these. And each one of these deep well plates, this is kind of vertical view, but think of it as, I won't say test tubes, but if you're going back to high school chemistry, they would go into these plates. They can hold up to 96 apiece samples in here. 100 of these plates will get us a 9,600 capacity, and this will help us get us back up to at least 1,875 tests per day by tomorrow. But again, I want to thank the lab team and everybody there that's exploring every option from private to public to make sure that we keep ourselves going.